So today we'll discuss on topic of digitization of your business processes. So let me introduce about my company to you. So Simtrax is into enterprise software solutions. We are having 30 plus years of industry experience. We are into technological innovation to fulfill customer needs. We have 3000 plus customers across different sectors. We talk about 7 years of average of customer loyalty. Moving further, we are having headquarters in Los Angeles and global presence, having offices worldwide. In India, we have the offices in Mumbai and Pune for APAC region. Agenda for today. So during COVID-19 crisis, we have seen some disruptions in the industry such as manufacturing, FMCG and pharmaceutical. And there are numerous questions being asked everywhere, like how to deal with this kind of situation in different business processes. So the answer to all those questions is digital transformation. The questions like, can we make manufacturing more competitive in higher cost environment? Then yes, through digital transformation. Or can we reduce back office team? Yes, through digitization. Then can we automate business process like PO to SO? Yes, through digitization. Then can we reduce approval cycle time? Yes, through digitization, and the list goes on. So digitization has always made sense, but adoption has been slow and organizations are struggling to figure out like where the value is coming and where they have to utilize it. So I can say digitization is must, and those fail to transform will likely to left behind, and the risk will increase to become incompetent. So our today's discussion will revolve around transitioning from paper-based to digital process, where we'll discuss business cases from the different industry. We'll discuss about Simtrax solution. And at the end of this webinar, we will have the question and answer session as well. So moving further, we will discuss typical routing of paper-based and digital process. So on the screen, you can see, now let's discuss about paper-based process. So let's assume you are receiving invoices from the vendor. In that case, either you will receive it through hard copy. Then for the different reminder purpose, you have to use sticky notes. If this is an approval process, then you have to send to the respective authority for the approval for that. You have to take the multiple printout, and then you have to store in the file cabinets. If you have to send it to the finance department for the payment clearance, then you have to merge purchase order, which is again paper-based and manual process. And then entire set, you have to store in file folders. Now let's discuss how we can digitize this process. Now you will receive the vendor invoice through email. Then it will be captured automatically. It will send to the respective authority intelligently. Then respective authority will approve that document. Then PO will be merged automatically. And then entire set will be stored in the respective, like we can push back in the DMS, or we can store in the file repositories, or we can store in respective folder like that. Now you can see here, this paper-based process is slow, opaque, internal, and vulnerable. But if you can see, this digital process is instant, trackable, hence it's transparent. So I can say in paper-based process, it moves with the speed of people, but in paperless process, it moves with a click of a button. Now moving further, now let's do some digging into your business processes. So there are some considerations for digitization. For example, how does the process begin? Now here you can take take example for HR process or PO to SO process. Now second, how and where document is received. So in PO to SO process, you will receive the document through email. Then who receives the document? Now your respective sales team will receive the document. Then where is the data or document being routed? Then here you have to sales team have to segregate every purchase order as per the customer wise. And then they have to create a sales order. Then fifth consideration, how and where documents are stored, and how is the stored document retrieved when needed. Now here, either you have to store in the respective repository, or you have to upload to SharePoint, or you have to store in share folder, or you have to push back in ERP. So likewise, you have to do the task. Now here, I would like to provide the example from the pharma industry. So we have one of the prospects where they have faced the challenges in terms of their digitization process. Now here, they have the process like they have to create the document in Word. Then they have to scan that document. Then they have to send to the respective authority for the approval. Once it approved, then they have to send this document to the European government. Once it approved from there, then on that document, they have to manually map all the ERP data. And final document, they have to sign it digitally. And then it will be available for the production process. So how we propose a solution for their existing process, where document either can create in the Compleo, or we can use their as it is document, then it will be approved from the respective authorities, then it will send to the European government for the approval. Once it approved from there, then automatically ERP data will be mapped to that document and the final document will be signed digitally either using dongle or using PFX file, and then it will be available for the batch process of production. Now, we will discuss in detail how it can be achieved using CompleU. Now on the screen, you can see this is the typical architecture of CompleU. Now on the left hand side, you can see the SAP ERP. So for SAP and IBM, there are the certified integrations. In the second box, you can see the different ERPs or applications. So if they're allowed API integration, then we can integrate using API connector. Also, we can capture the documents from the email as we have the email connector, or we can use the PC folder approach as well. Now, from ERPs, when document is processed, it will be captured in CompleU either using SAP certified connector or using API connector depending upon the ERP used, and then predefined template will be applied on that document automatically in the background, and then final output will be created and distributed. Now on the right hand side, you can see multi-channel distribution platform where document is sent via email, it can be printed, it can archive, it can send for workflow for approval, it can convert into XML, it can push back in DMS, or it can store on cloud repositories like SAP, Amazon and Bucket, Amazon S3 Bucket, etc. Similar process will be carried out for like email, office suite, and PC folders. Now let's have a quick poll. Vijita and Tejas, if you're online, can you just insert the question, because I'm not able to do that due to technical
sure.
error.
I will do that for you.
Yeah. Yeah, when you're planning to digitize your document management process. So first on priority, second under consideration, third not considered so far, and fourth point already implemented. So I request you to cast your vote. So of course it will be depend upon the challenges that you're facing right now in different business processes, or it will be depending upon the mandate from the customer and in terms of digitizing your business document with digital signature. Yeah, thank you so much for your voting. Moving further, I would like to discuss a business case from the manufacturing industry. This customer is from the Oman. So we have helped them to digitize their existing order to cash process. So before using CompleU, they have to manually do the further process of merging of this delivery order and purchase order, which they are receiving from the customer. And then they have to deliver to the customer, which is again manual process. Now, due to this process, their finance department were facing challenges for the payment collection. So using CompleU, we help them to entirely merge the state, which is an invoice, delivery order and purchase order, and we have sent them over email to the customer. So in this way, we help them to reduce their manual efforts and we help them to fasten their payment cycle as well. Moving further, let's discuss about electronic data interchange. So this business case is from the paint industry. So we have the customer from the paint industry. So they are already using our solution for digital signature. Like the process is, their SAP user, they process the document from SAP through SAP certified connector. The documents are captured in CompleU. Now, the documents are signed centrally using HSN. After that, we have sent this document for the printing in the respective location. Now, after this process, their customer demanded that they want to have digital signed document to their portal. Okay, and they have provided the API as well. So using Compleo, we have converted that format to the hexadecimal format, and through given API, we have uploaded that document to their respective ERP platform. So in this way, we help them to digitize their end-to-end business process. So let's have a quick poll. Yeah, I can do that. Yeah. So does your document exchange process include the various file formats? So first option is yes, second is no. So it could be PDF, it could be XML, it could be CSV file. So using Compleo, we can read PDF, XML, CSV, text formats, and we can convert them into required format as well. So I request you to cast your vote. Yeah, thank you so much for your voting. Moving further, I would like to discuss the business case from the Behrin. So they are facing challenges in terms of account payable process. Now they're having almost 250 different authorities in 35 different departments. So they are facing challenges in terms of cross-team approval challenges, because they're every department having 3 to 4 authorities, and finance department also they're having 2 to 3 authorities. Now this entire process is manual, hence it's time consuming. So using Compleo, we help them to digitize their entire business process, where vendor will send invoices through email, we will capture it Compleo, we will send to the respective authority for the approval, and PO invoice will be merged automatically. And once finance department approves that, then vendor payment will be processed. In case invoice is rejected, then vendor will be notified. Now here, the higher management of this organization, they're receiving the complaints from the vendors because they are receiving the payment delay. So we can create the reports department wise, like which authorities is making time for the approval, what is the average cycle time for the approval. So accordingly, higher management will receive the report either month end or weekend or as they require. Moving further, now let's discuss the demonstration for workflow. So here I have taken the example of non-ERP document, which is expense sheet. So same way, we can have the demonstration for ERP documents as well. Like you can simply process the document from your ERP as well. You can see here, this is the expense sheet, which is a predefined format. And this is attached to bills as well. Now, the creator of the document, he can simply save this document from his desktop. As I mentioned, you can process the document from your ERP as well. Now, in the background, document will be captured and then document will send to the respective authority automatically. Now you can see here, respective authority has received this email. Now he can simply click on this link. Once he click on this link, then based upon the login ID credential, this web console will open. Authority on the left hand side, you can check the metadata from this document. We can configure this metadata as you requested. Now on the right hand side, you can see this is a document along with the attached bills as well. Now authority can simply approve this document, or he can add ink signature or digital signature. If you want to fetch some data from your respective database, we can bring that as well. Now, once authority signs this document, it will go to the next level of authority. So next level of authority, for example, here finance it. And as well, like we can send email notifications as well in between. Now next authority receives this document, he will simply do the same process. He will have his own login ID and credentials. Now he can check it out the previous manager's signature, and he can simply approve this document along with the ink signature or digital signature. Now, once document is approved, if it is the final authority, then the creator of the document will receive the attachment, which is having the signatures for both the authorities. Now, you can see on the screen, this is attachment. We can archive the link as well in the email body. Let me open that document for you. Yeah, this is signature from the both the authorities. Now, if you like to push back this document in your ERP, or if you like to store in respective DMS, we can do that. So this is the company DMS, which is a company archiver. So based upon the login and credential, you can open that. You can see here, based upon the authorization, the respective authority can view only his documents. Now, based upon the metadata, you can filter the document. Now, here I would like to add, like, you can save this document from here. You can email the document from here. You can manually upload the document from here. You can put the comment as well, likewise. Also, if you like to have the reports, we can do that as well. So you can see on the screen, this document, we can filter it based upon the archiving date. You can see here, this signature is from only one authority. Similar way, you can find out the document along with the second authority signature based upon the archiving date. Like this. So this is the document management solution for storage and retrieval. Moving further, let's have a quick poll. So how important is it for you to have digitized distribution? So first, yes, very important. Second, good to have. Third, not important. And fourth, haven't thought about it. So here you could consider distribution via EDI or through data exchange or via portal or through SFTP approach, etc. So I request you to cast your vote. Yeah, thank you so much for your voting. Moving further, now we'll discuss the another application, which is e-signature. So this e-signature you can apply when you like to have the real-time acknowledgement from the customer for goods delivered or document delivered. Or nowadays HR doing recruitment online, and if HR would like to have signed document from the new joinee, so simply HR can process the document from desktop, and then automatically new joinee will receive the document over email. He can simply review it and he can simply sign this document, and both will receive the document for the reference. Now let's see the demonstration for that. You can see here. Now here I will take example of the delivery order. So you have to simply process this document either through folder or from ERP. Now immediately the document will send to the respective customer over email. So respective customer will simply click on that link. Additional security level will be like respective customer will receive the security code on the register mobile number. They have to simply put it here and he can view this document. Now, if you have the business scenario where at customer end you have the multiple authorities, then also we'll discuss what will be the case. Now you can see here, the first customer will simply sign this document and he can simply send this document. Now, as I mentioned, if customer having the multiple authorities, then automatically document will route to the next authority. Once final authority from the customer end sign this document, then you will receive this document automatically, and customer will also receive this document for the reference. Now, once you have the delivery order which is signed from the customer, then you can do the further process. For example, you can simply go in ERP and you can process the document. Now, here this is the invoice. Now, if you want to sign this document digitally, then you can sign it either through dongle or through PFX. So for the digital signature, we will discuss in detail after this slide. Now, once you can see here, this is a client software, so authority can simply sign this document. Now, we have the additional functionality, like we can archive the entire set and we can deliver to required recipient. Now I can show you that. Now you can see required entire set will be delivered to required recipient over email. Now this is the signed, digitally signed invoice. Then this is the purchase order that we received from the customer, and then this is the sales order, and then this is the delivery order signed by customer. Moving further, now let's discuss about digital signature. Now here, digital signature, we have the two approaches. First approach is a distributed approach, and second approach is a centralized approach. So in distributed approach, you have to use dongle. So dongle that need to be plugged on authority system, and client software need to be installed on authority system. Now the process will be the remain same. Like you have to simply process the document from your ERP. It will be captured automatically in Compleo. It will route to the respective authority system. And then authority will review this document and then it will be signed and then it will be distributed likewise. Now here benefits are authority can review this document before signing and he will be accountable for this process. Another consideration like there should be connectivity between signatory system and Compleo server. Now we will discuss the process for centralized architecture. Now here you don't need to plug dongle on authority system because PFX and or HXM will be installed on Compleo server. Okay, now the process will be remain same. That you will process the document from ERP, it will be captured in Compleo, it will be signed centrally and then it will be distributed as required. Now it's quite useful in bulk signing when validation is not required. But the challenges are like single level security may create a security concern if proper security features are not in place in your premise. Also, the PFX will be available on the organization's name only. In for HXM, like it will be very costly to procure and maintain. Now let's have a quick poll. So where do you stand in digital signature adoption? So first, have solution but with manual intervention. Second, have solution with automated signing. Then third, looking for a solution and then no plans. So you already have the solution. Then if you are facing challenges in terms of any like distribution or in terms of signing, then we can discuss. If you are the manual solution, but if you like to explore either through dongle or PFX, then also we will discuss in detail. So I request you to cast your vote. Yeah. Thank you so much for your voting. Moving further, now we'll discuss in detail about the demonstration. Now here, I will use SAP environment for the demonstration. You can see on the screen. Now first, I will show you the distributed approach using dongle. Now this is the invoice. Now if you like to have the digital signature at the top of the document or on the bottom of the document, then also it will be configured. So as a SAP user, I will simply process this document from SAP. And then automatically this document will send to the respective authority and the respective authority will get notifications as well on his desktop. Now you can see here notification has received. So authority simply click on that and either he can approve or he can reject the document. Let's suppose I have signed this document. Now automatically once it's signed, then it will be distributed over email to required recipient. So let me show you that. You can see here, this is a digital signed document and we have archived a link in the email body as well. So let me show you that. Now we have the additional functionality where we can reformat your existing ERP document, where we can add customized QR code. So as per the government mandate for the dynamic QR code requirement for the B2C invoices, we can do that as well. We can add multi-language text, we can add multi-specific barcode, we can add e-signature, then we can add bank details. Also, very important, we can add like marketing campus in the footer. Also, we can make it a two-page document. So based upon the customer ID and customer name, we can fetch the right contract and we can display it here. So which is also dynamic in nature. And for the centralized architecture, you have to simply process the document and automatically you will receive the signed document over email. So as I mentioned it, we can push back document back to DMS. So here, this is a SAP DMS window where we have pushed back digital signed document back to SAP DMS. You can see here. This is the signed document. Now, you know the other ERP apart from SAP, then we can push back the document in respective to the DMS as well. Now, you must have the query in your mind. What about like when you are using dongle and if you want to have the auto signing option? So we have that option as well, where like authorities simply have to click on this option, let the remote agent sign documents automatically, and then I will go in ERP and I will simply process this document. So in bulk processing, you can use this option when authority don't want to review that document, but he want to have the signed document automatically. So you have to simply process the document from the. Now let me go in the client software. Now document is signed centrally. You can see here documents are signing automatically, and then it will be distributed over email or it as requested. You can see here, this is the digital signed document. So moving further, let's have a look on customers. So we have 3000 plus customers, as I mentioned it, and we are not an industry specific solution provider. So in manufacturing industry, we have the customers like Volkswagen, Volvo, Asian Paints, Tata Chemicals, etc. In finance industry, we have the customers like Citibank, HSBC, etc. In FMCG and food industry, we have the customers like Coca-Cola, Bacardi, Haribo, etc. Moving further, in pharma industry, we have the customers like Himalaya, Pfizer, etc. And in other industries, we have the customers like Dainik Bhaskar, Times Publishing Group, etc. So if you decided to go for digitization of any of your business processes, so some factors will be helpful and will influence your decision. So we are the Simtrax, we can help you to digitize your business processes. So using Compleo, we can do that. So Compleo acts as an admin tool. There's no any programming efforts are required. And as I mentioned, we have the SAP and IBM certified integrations. For other ERPs, we can use API connector. So in short, it's a one-stop solution for automation and digitization with multi-channel distribution. So using Compleo, we can help you to add value to your existing ERP setup, and this is for sure. So thank you so much for your valuable time. If you have any queries, you can feel free to text us in the chat window so we can address that. And if you would like to like schedule the demo for your team or your different stakeholders, we can do that as per your convenience. So we are open for the discussion. I request you, if you have any queries, so we can discuss right now. Thank you so much for your time.
Okay, so thank you so much, Jagruti, for the wonderful webinar. I hope it was beneficial to all the attendees today. Jagruti, can you confirm if I'm properly audible?
Yeah, Tejas, you can audible. Yeah.
Okay, so we just have a few questions here that I would like to address. So the first question which has been presented was, can we have multiple digital signatures on one document and also sign all pages? Yeah, you can definitely have that based on certain hierarchy or condition-based logic, and also it's possible to sign all pages now. The next question we have here is again on digital signature. So can we sign digitally sign multiple copies of the same invoice? Yes, you can do that. So the scenarios where there are 3, 4, or 5 copies being generated for distribution or providing to different business partners, we can segregate them, or we can capture them as required and sign them as separate and provide the same to you. Then the next question we have here is, how do you differentiate documents based on its type, location, or some customized condition, etc.? Okay, so like Jagruti had showed during the demo, we are able to read the spool files for SAP or IBM documents, or we can read the PDFs, CSVs, or XML files which come as input to us. Now we can define specific conditions on the required parameters, so which could be the customer name, customer number, or any kind of a basically master data, so the material or the state or the address. And based on these, we could differentiate between the documents. Also, we could put up a differentiation based on whether it's an invoice or a purchase order being detected on the document, and we can take the necessary process to be set up. The next question is, how quick is the solution to implement for digitization projects? So now that timeline could be anywhere between probably 1 week to 3 or 4 working weeks, depending on size and amplitude of the project. So for signing projects, it could take 1 to 2 working weeks, depending on the kind of setup we have. In case of bigger setup, it could take some additional time. But then once we discuss the project in detail, we could provide the timeline in a better form. This question is, what are different methods supported for file or data transfer via EDI or electronic medium? Okay. So here, the different methodologies like API-based transfer or FTP or SFTP-based transfer or directly mailing in custom format. So these kind of activities can be taken care of when we electronically try to transfer the data. The next question we have is, will the solution be on-premise or on-cloud? So it could be either on-premise or on-cloud or a combination of both, depending on the kind of project we go for. So for example, the digital signature would be on-prem, the electronic signature could be on-cloud. And if it's an integration with the ERP, it could be a hybrid solution. The next question we have is, our ERP is at a global level and based outside India, how do you handle the same? Okay. So here we need to understand where is the ERP system based and where can we host the server for installation of our software. Or we also need to understand if it's going to be a SaaS-based application. And based on the application and architecture to be defined, we can handle the same. Because we do cater to customers whose centralized ERPs are based out of Europe or Singapore or maybe Middle East. So we do that. The next question we have here is, we have different requirements in terms of process execution and distribution based on customer demands. How do we handle that? So like I said, we have different ways to identify and differentiate between different kinds of documents. We identify them, differentiate them, and then we can call a relevant template based on satisfaction of certain conditions. So accordingly, if there are different demands of customers or different demands of different processes, we could address the same by differentiating files and applying the relevant templates. So that's all the questions I have so far. If anybody has any other questions, I request you to put them up in the chat box. I think we'll be here online for a few more minutes and we'll be more than happy to answer if you have any questions. Apart from that, the contact details are flashing on the screen, so you can always reach out to us if there are any queries later on, or if you want any specific session to be organized for your team and other stakeholders at the organization. I request the attendees to put up questions in the chat box if they have any. So we'll be there online for a few more minutes and you can let us know in case of questions. Over to you, Jagruti.
Yeah, thank you so much, Tejas. So as I mentioned it, in terms of digitization and automation, if you like to discuss any of your business process, we can have the demonstration or we can have the telephonic call initially after your convenience. So I request you can let us know. And also the recording of this webinar will be shared. Yeah, so thank you so much for your time for this webinar, and we will post you for our remaining webinars as well. So thank you so much. Yeah.